We are here in the Boreal Forest in Canada to learn a bit more about the ecology in this region as well as the forestry practices that are employed. It is important that as a company, Georgia Pacific understands both the risks as well as the dynamics that exist in each of the regions that we're sourcing wood so that we can live up to our commitment to be good stewards of the land. In Canada and in the Boreal Forest in particular, there is very little deforestation that is a result of the forest products industry. That being said, part of the forest management plan is to understand the impact that forestry operations will have on carbon storage, on wildlife habitat, on the biodiversity of the land to ensure that they are managing the impact and minimizing it as much as possible.
Sustainability in our business means never running out of trees. We ensure that the last tree in Ontario will never be harvested because it's always renewed and always planned for a sustainable business. I love to see new trees planted on the site. I love to see how fast they're growing, how healthy they are. It just gives me a good sense that what we're doing is sustainable over time and into the future for future generations of foresters and consumers.
This is one of the best places for caribou in Ontario. There's some forest industry here, but if you go a little bit further north, there's basically a lot of woods and not much else.
Forest fire and insect infestation are a part of the ecosystem here, so when harvesting activity takes place, what we try to do is mimic those disturbances and ensure that the ecosystem is as it would have been through these natural disturbances.
There are some animals in the forest that actually need young forest. Caribou not only need a mature forest for their winter habitat, but they also need young forest for foraging. There are several birds that thrive in young forests and cannot exist in only old forests. Moose, for example, that need old fore cover in the summer heat and need the forage in the fall and the winter months. We partner with Indigenous people by meeting them face to face, one on one, and in groups, finding out what their needs and wants are, making sure their values are taken into account and protected. A lot of them are our forest workers, and they're part of the community. They hunt, they fish, they gather within the very forest that we manage.
Probably the largest takeaway that we've had from this trip is that the forestry practices really take all of the ecological and social considerations in mind when they're establishing their plan to harvest.